Welcome to today's video tutorial. In this tutorial, we'll be covering the general procedures for modding the 2006 PC version of Marvel Ultimate Alliance. This video covers the overall procedure for modding your game. Other more specific procedures will be covered in later videos. Additionally, you can find a written version of this very tutorial that covers this information and more in depth within the description of this video. Before you mod the game, you need to, of course, have the game installed. If you don't already own it, you can find a free, legal, archived copy on archive.org. Here's how to install it. Once you visit the link, choose to download the ISO image over on the right side. This will download the installer ISO for the game. After the installer ISO has finished downloading, right-click on it and choose the option to mount. This will put the ISO in a virtual disk drive and allow you to view the file contents. Open the files and scroll down to find setup.exe. This will run the installation of Marvel Ultimate Alliance on your PC. Follow along with the steps provided by the game installer. A typical setup is recommended. If you don't already have DirectX 9 installed on your computer, choose the option to install it when you're asked. Once the installation is complete, you'll see the launcher for the game. You can now press quit, since the game won't start if you press play right now. There are a few things you'll need to do to ensure that the game will run correctly on modern computers. First of all, go back to the installer ISO that you downloaded, and navigate to the folder called Crack. In this folder, you'll find a file called game.exe. This file allows you to play the game on Windows 10. To use it, simply copy it into your game files, replacing the original. The default installation for the game files is C, Program Files x86, Activision. Additionally, it's recommended to move your game files to a location that isn't protected by administrator privileges, such as your documents or desktop. To do this, simply cut and paste the entire Activision folder from Program Files x86 to the folder of your choice. Before moving on, we'd like to point out a few things about modding. First off, we recommend using Mod Organizer 2 to install mods to the PC version of Ultimate Alliance. This program, created by Tenin and others over at Nexus Mods, is useful for keeping your mod files separate from each other. You can choose which files overwrite each other, and you can easily install, toggle, and remove mods with a simple click. The full procedure is explained in the written version of this tutorial, which you can find in the description of this video. The last thing that's important to note is that Ultimate Alliance has certain limits to how extensively you can mod it. We've done our best to research the limits, but not everything is completely clear-cut. You can find full descriptions of the known game limits in the description of this video. Now that you've installed the game, it's time to start modding it. Most mods are very simple to install. All you have to do is drag and drop the files from the download into your game files. The easiest way to do this is to line the files up next to each other so that the folders are the same, and then simply drag them from one to the other. If you're asked to overwrite any files, choose to do so. The order that you install mods does matter. The links to all the mods are provided in the written version of this tutorial. The very first mod you should always install is the latest version of the official characters pack. This is a prerequisite for all other mods. Once you've installed the official characters pack, you can optionally choose to install either the 36 roster hack or the 50 roster hack. Neither of these mods are required, but they allow you to expand the roster size for your game. Next, you can choose to install any character mods that you're interested in. You can find them in the Character Mod Catalog or the Non-Marvel Character Mod Catalog. After you've installed your character mods, you can optionally choose to install any boosters for those characters. These can be found in the Booster Catalog and the Non-Marvel Booster Catalog. If you'd like to change the appearance of any of your characters, you can next choose to optionally install any skins you'd like. You can find links in the Skin Thread catalog. Full details on how to install skins can be found in the written version of this tutorial. We will also be making a video to cover it at a later date. Lastly, you can choose to install any other miscellaneous mods, such as sound packs. If you intend to make any changes to your roster, you must now change your hero stat. This is the last thing you should do after installing mods, but before running the game. Full information how to do this can be found in the written version of this tutorial, and videos covering the topic will be created at a later time. Remember, any time you make changes to your hero stat, you must start a new save file. Once you've done all that, you're now ready to play the game. Often, when you add a mod character to the game, they will be seemingly locked. To be able to play as them, you can either use the cheat code to unlock all characters, or you can unlock specific characters through scripts. Full information on the scripting method is mentioned in the written version of this tutorial. Lastly, if you're using one of the roster hacks, and your characters are having issues executing melee combat animations, you can use the Unlock All Powers cheat code to fix this problem. With all this information, you're now ready to mod your game. If you have further questions about any of the information, first, check out the written version of the tutorial. If you still need help, feel free to come by our community Discord server and ask any questions you may have there. We'd like to thank every single one of you for watching this video. If you've enjoyed it, well, why not check out some of our other content too? Feel free to leave comments down below, but please do try to keep it civil. If you want to experience any mods shown off in our videos, check out and join our community over at www.marvelmods.com or our official Discord server. Links are in the description. See you all next time.